You can create a variety of fun projects with the FHSM-505A multifunctional domestic sewing machine. This machine is easy to use for beginning and advanced sewers alike. Its features include sewing sleeves, automatic thread rewind, and 8 different stitches to make your sewing more colorful. It comes with a built-in sewing light and adjustable high and low speed. You can change the presser foot to sew different fabrics and crafts. And you can use either batteries or the power adapter. Features such as forward and reverse sewing, a drawer, a built-in thread cutter, and a foot paddle will make your sewing more fun and convenient than ever. Now, let's look at the parts of the machine. There is the take-up lever, upper thread tension dial, needle clamp and screw, bottom bobbin, pattern selection dial, hand wheel, reverse lever, power and speed switch, thread cutter, the light and the button to turn it on, drawer, bobbin winder pin, bobbin winder stop, foot paddle input, AC, DC, power input, bobbin winder tension disc, presser foot lifter, presser foot, and battery compartment. Now that we know all the parts, we can get ready to sew. Before you use the machine, make sure the power stitch is in the off position to avoid accidentally turning the machine on. Installing the batteries or plugging the machine in. You can power this machine with 4 AA batteries or the power adapter. Always make sure the power stitch is in the off position before inserting the batteries or connecting the adapter. If you are using batteries, remove the battery cover. Place the batteries in the compartment with the correct polarity and replace the cover. Or if you're using the adapter, connect the jack to the AC-DC input socket on the back of the machine and connect the plug to the main power supply. Don't forget to remove the batteries or unplug the adapter when you're not using machine or when you're setting it up. Using the foot paddle. Connect the foot paddle by inserting the jack into the foot paddle input socket. Then you can use the foot paddle to turn on the machine instead of using the hand switch, so it's easy and convenient. Caution! Make sure the foot paddle is unplugged from the machine when you're not using it, so the sewing machine won't accidentally start up. Threading the machine. Winding the bobbin. After use of the bobbin thread, you can use the machine to wind one more thread. First, put an empty bobbin on the bobbin winder pin. Push the bobbin to the right, towards the hand wheel, to fix the bobbin. Unwind some thread from a bigger spool. Put a thread around the bobbin winder tension disc. Put it through any one of the metal holes in the bobbin. Hold onto the thread. Wind the thread clockwise around the bobbin several times and turn on the power switch to start winding. When you have enough thread wound on, turn off the power switch to stop winding. Push the bobbin to the left, away from the hand wheel. Cut the thread and take the bobbin off. Caution! Make sure there is no thread in the machine before you wind a new bobbin, because this could jam the thread. Threading the upper thread. Put a spool on the thread spindle, then put on a thread spindle cover. Put a thread so it passes through the bobbin winder tension disc. Then through the gap, pull it back up as the arrow shows, through the take-up lever, then through the hole next to the needle clamp screw. Easily thread the needle by sticking the needle threader through the eye from back to front. Put the thread through the wire of the threader and pull the threader back out. Caution! The needle eye must be threaded from front to back for the sewing machine to work. Replacing the bobbin. Slide the bobbin cover off and remove the empty bobbin. Put the new bobbin in the holder with the thread going clockwise. Leave 5 to 10 cm of thread hanging out. Hold the needle thread with one hand and with the other hand, turn the hand wheel counterclockwise, and the needle thread will pick up the bobbin thread and pull it up through the hole under the needle. Separate the two threads and pull them to the back of the machine under the presser foot, leaving about 15 cm hanging there. Now replace the bobbin cover. Caution! Always make sure the bobbin thread has been picked up with about 15 cm hanging out before you start to sew. Replacing the needle. To prevent injury from accidentally starting up the machine, make sure to turn up the switch and remove the batteries or the plug. Hold the old needle and loosen the needle clamp screw. Remove the needle and discard it responsibly. Insert a new needle into the clamp with the flat side of the needle facing the back. Toward the presser foot bar, be sure to push the needle all the way up, then tighten the screw. Caution! Always remove the batteries or unplug the adapter before you change the needle. Make sure the new needle faces the right way and the screw is tightened. Presser foot replacement. Removing the presser foot. Turn the hand wheel counterclockwise to raise the needle to its highest position. Raise the presser foot lifter and press the presser foot locking lever. The presser foot will drop off automatically from the locking device. Installing the presser foot. Put the presser foot under the presser foot locking device. Lower the presser foot lifter. Press the presser foot locking device to reset the foot. And lift the presser foot lifter. If the foot has been picked up, then you're done. If not, check to make sure the foot is exactly under the locking device and repeat the steps. Once you are done setting up the machine, you can start to sew. Sewing. First, turn the hand wheel counterclockwise to raise the needle to its highest position. Second, raise the presser foot lifter and place the fabric you want to sew under the presser foot. Third, lower the presser foot. Fourth, turn the hand wheel counterclockwise several times to make sure there is no jamming in the stitches. Fifth, slide the power switch to the low or high speed position and the machine will automatically start sewing. We recommend the low speed for beginners. Sixth, turn off the switch, turn on the hand wheel counterclockwise to raise the needle to the highest position. Turn the pattern selection dial and set the number of the dial to the below arrow direction, and the machine will perform at the corresponding numbered stitches listed beside. Here, I randomly choose 3, 7, 2 to sew. Caution! When you want to change stitch type, stop sewing and turn the hand wheel to raise the needle all the way up so it doesn't get bent. 7. To sew backwards, press and hold down the reverse lever while you are sewing. Caution! You should only use reverse sewing on straight stitches. This is useful when reinforcing the seam. 8. When you're finishing sewing, turn off the stitch, unplug the adapter, turn a hand wheel to raise the needle all the way up, lift the presser foot, and then gently remove the fabric from the sewing machine and cut the thread with the thread cutter. Caution! If it's difficult to remove the fabric, turn a hand wheel to raise the needle bar to the highest position and gently pull the fabric out. Now, in case you have trouble using the machine, we'll go over some common problems and the solutions. Important safety instructions. 1. Always disconnect from the power supply when changing the needle. 2. Children should only use the appliance with adult supervision. 3. Never run the machine when there is thread in the needle, but no fabric on the machine. This could damage the machine. 4. Don't use the machine outdoors. 5. Whenever the sewing machine is not in use, make sure it is switched off and unplugged from the power supply. 6. Keep the machine in a dry and ventilated place. 7. This machine is not a toy. 8. Do not mix old and new batteries. 9. Don't disassemble the machine unless you are a professional. If you are using batteries, take them out when you are not using the machine.